They're forming flock, like this one. You see here? Then Omara says the possibility of the blackout is upper side. So key news updates. Kraken discloses staking volume for Flow is 725 million in less than 2 months. This is an amazing achievement on the Flow Bus project. Why? Because current market cap of Flow is around 1 billion. Over 70% of the Flow holder, they're going to decide staking for their token investment. Which means that, of course, you know, this number includes lock-up period of the ICO project. It's going to happen in last October. But still, this number is pretty positive stats for the market developments on token economy of the Flow. If the Flow, the project itself, keeping their amazing tractions at their game NFT market development stuff, of course, they can maintain these stats after the end of the lock-up period, which can happen this October 2021. So let's continuously pay attention to their business development progress. Then, what about their business development progress? Vitaly, the cryptocurrency research company, recently released the traction of an NFT marketplace, especially secondary sales volume on a marketplace, and an NFT Top Shot, the major dApps game on the front blockchain, hit number one positioning. But also, these stats is pretty amazing because 322 million in a secondary sales volume is almost triple than the second player here. Huge success. Amazing. Okay? Then chart analysis of Flow. So March 4th, it's gonna hit all-time high, 41.2512. And after this, we're gonna experience certain level of price pressure moments. But looks like now they are forming flock, like this one. You see here? Then Omara says the possibility of the blackout is upper side from this chart analysis, okay? And then leading market updates, Bus Market. So major Bus active stats since last Monday, all the stats from dApps.com. And then there is a three major Bus project, Ethereum, Tron, and EOS. And then this week, especially what I pay attention to, these stats. Active user base. Tron more focused on gamble and game applications. And Ethereum more seriously focused on DeFi applications. So, active user base perspective, of course, Tron stats is higher than Ethereum. But these days, DeFi market development is skyrocketing. That is why active user base here almost reached 50% of the Tron active user base. So huge market progress happening in Ethereum platform. This is great, okay? And the ETH gas cost fee, March 14th, plus 40%. Not that quite expensive one, $70.83, cheaper than Bitcoin, okay? And the Grayscale investment ETH assets, plus 21% increase. Amazing. So here, so looks like pretty bullish momentum coming to the Ethereum market right now, okay? And what about CME? ETH futures, 1 month price difference average. Last week was 26, this week was 26.25, so plus 1%. Almost no change, okay? Next one, BNB. Let's check out the key news first. So CFTC investigates Binance over concerns that US trader illegally utilized platform. Binance actually have the US, you know, exchange. So with this matter, actually there is no problem. But if the US trader use the Binance accounts, not a Binance US accounts, and then they're gonna do some kind of derivative trading, it's gonna be a huge problem. Then since current Binance market is pretty hot because of the, you know, Coinbase IPO effect with the over $100 billion market cap, so these news, it's kind of a little bit risky for us, so we need to pay attention to this news progress. Okay, this is pretty important. Then once we're gonna move to chart analysis, daily chart and weekly chart. Daily chart basis, first thing I want you to pay attention to these flag formations. So after, on February 19th, they're gonna hit all-time high 348, flag forming like this way. And along with it, middle line of this Bollinger Band function like supporting line here. So finally, BNB price experiences bullish breakout with this flag formations. But at the same time, once BNB price hit upper price line of this Bollinger Band, price is pushed back again. Okay? So still, these price range movement between middle line of the Bollinger Band, upper line of the Bollinger Band, it's price range movement on BNB token as of now. Okay? Then once we're gonna look at more longer term vision on BNB weekly basis, and actually EMA 8 function just like support line on this market. So if the Bitcoin price experiences huge price crash, BNB tokens also experiences certain level of the big price crash, but these stats will be the support line. So currently, these stats indicate around $200, okay? This is kind of a support line with this price movement on a BNB token as of now, okay? And the next one, Uniswap. So let's start for the key news updates. Uni surges plus 50% in just 1 week. Becomes first DeFi DApp stock in crypto top 10. Amazing achievement. Then why Uniswap tokens these days also surging? Because Coinbase IPO effects with 100 billion market cap. Coinbase is a centralized exchange. Uniswap is a DEX. So the future of the exchange is DEX. That's why. Okay. Then once we're going to move to chart analysis, for a chart, and a weekly chart here. And for a chart, first of all, March 8th, Uniswap token hit all-time high, 34.9277. Great. Then, once we're gonna pay attention to technical chart analysis, looks like middle line with this Bollinger Band function like resistance line. But since Unitoken is much more volatile than Bitcoin, so these technical indicators sometimes are hitting deeper side here. We have to be a little patient with this kind of, you know, higher volatility here. But once we're gonna move to weekly chart basis, looks like EMA 8 also function like support line here. Even we're gonna experience this kind of pretty big gap, price all the time push back again, and currently we have this kind of gap here. So if the Bitcoin price also crash again, unit token price will also experience a certain level of price clash, and the current price target is around 25. Around this area here, okay? The next one, BAU, Balancer. Let's start with the key news. Balancer is coming to Polkadot via Moonbeam. As I told you many times, next big things on the DEX market is cross-chain transactions. And the blockchain interoperability project Polkadot is a major player who can work on, you know, cross-chain DEX market. Then finally, Balancer joined this ecosystem through the Moonbeam blockchain. You know, it's pretty good execution model to compete with Uniswap. Okay, so it's pretty good news. Now with this news, bullish momentum comes to Balancer market too. Technical analysis, daily chart and weekly chart. March 15th, they're gonna update an all-time high, $57. Then currently it looks like EMA 34 function like support line here in the market. If the Bitcoin price experiences certain level of price clash, price might hit over here again. Price range around here is 43. Then once we're gonna move to weekly chart here, EMA 8 on a weekly chart basis function like support line here, right? Then actually they're gonna indicate the same price range here about price pushback here, $43. Then another elements about bearish signal that we need to pay attention to is RSI here. As you can see here, gradually downtrend on RSI might come to this market, so let's pay attention to this. Okay, and DeFi DEX market updates. So as usual, trading volume comparison between central exchange and DEX. Last week was 4.3 to 1. This week 6.9 to 1. So a little bit widening again. The reason is, last week, as I told you on my Bitcoin analysis, Bitcoin market dominance rate is increasing. So a lot of fiat money pair on the crypto space, like US dollar Bitcoin market, was pretty hot. So centralized exchange stats is much growing than decentralized exchange stats here, okay? So that's the reason for the stats. But at the same time, I still want to pay attention to these centralized exchange DEX protocol stats number here, like MDEX, Rama, Hopi. But simply say, this is not so healthy for this market development of DEX space. Pure DEX players such as Uniswap should take the market lead, okay, continuously. That's my point. All right, so the last slide. HODL is the best for retail investor to minimize the risk and maximize the return. Because investment in altcoin, just like investment in early days of Google and Facebook. And once we're gonna look at the regional angel investor, such as Ron Conway, Peter Thiel, Reid Hoffman, all the time they're gonna take the simple investment approach, is long-term investment. And here's another evidence from the Binance research. All the time, longest holder of the crypto assets maximize the investment return. In this case, it's a Bitcoin. Longest holder of the Bitcoin maximize the investment return with 220% return compared with short-term holder here. So I'm gonna also basically take the long-term investment. I'm gonna also recommend you guys to take the same approach too, okay? All right, so that is all this time. So I'm gonna make this video for the educational purpose. So I cannot guarantee you any kind of certain level of investment outcome with this video or any other video that I make. But I truly hope that my video will practically help you guys understand about huge potential about crypto and blockchain space. So I'm gonna make a lot of in this video on crypto and blockchain space. So thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Bye.